Okay, let's move along to the next model, because this one really knocked me out. A few months ago, we had the 143rd version of this car come through as made by Spark, and it was just such a beautiful car and such a great homage to an earlier machine that when we got this model from Minichamps of the simply incredible Mercedes SLS AMG. What else can you say? The very first Mercedes to be designed completely in-house from the ground up by AMG. This has the M159 V8, 378 cubes, about 6.2 liters, making 563 horsepower, 7-speed transmission. This, of course, is the car that's going to replace the McLaren, has replaced the McLaren. And this is, of course, an homage to the Gullwing Mercedes, the 300 SL and the SLR from years and years ago. Just a beautiful, beautiful car. I guess the PlayStation folks think so, because they made it the cover car for Gran Turismo 5. This is an outstanding looking model car. I love the Minichamps models for a couple of reasons. First of all, they have their own unique aesthetic. They're very solidly built cars. To my ears and my eyes, when I open and close the doors, everything is solid. They are very heavy model cars, really finely polished models. And of course, when you open them up, there's a lot of good stuff to see beneath. Let's put it over on the overhead camera and take a quick look. Beautiful, beautiful metallic red paint on this car. Everything is installed perfectly. The shut lines are absolutely even. Beautiful detail pieces put in for the lensing, the glazing, the fill cap, everything. Some foil appliques in the back on the trunk lid and a nice Mercedes roundel. Now we have an opening hood and a long one. I'll tell you, opening doors, true gullwing doors. They don't have that cantilever action that the McLaren car had. And of course, we have an opening trunk in the back. It is a very solid, very beautifully crafted model car. And I've just had just a little time with it. It came in earlier this week. Very impressive stuff. Let's take a look at some of the finer details. Now, of course, this is a plate casting on the engine. It's not a full engine, but you get the idea, the basic visual that you would get with the real car. There's not an awful lot to see on these machines. They've got some carbon fiber look plastics on the side, mostly plastic. Now we'll go to the interior, which is very nicely done. Beautiful dash gauges. Of course, the steering wheel with all of the push button controls. Nice center stack with the carbon fiber detailing. Let's take a look on the other side. Very pretty. I think it was Road and Track did a really nice piece on these machines, and they had Hemingway's son drive the car. Apparently Hemingway was a real, had an interesting attitude about automobiles. I'll put it to you that way. Here's that foil-based badging on the back, the AMG badging, and you get a better idea of just how pretty the paint is on this. Gorgeous brakes. They are not pass-through units. They're static pieces. This one is moving along with the wheel. Perhaps this one in the back is just a little bit loose, but it's not playing along with the wheel. On display, they give a great impression of the cross-drilled brake rotors. And underneath the car, this is why the car has such a great weight distribution. There's the transaxle, and there is the engine. Nice, nice piece. These are on the market for about $95. As I always suggest, you could check out Carville.com, who are the retail arm of Minichamps North America, or you can go to the Minichamps North America site, MinichampsNA.com. Very pretty piece, especially if you're a Mercedes fan.